Okay, here we are at the junction of Wood Lane, which is on my left, and the Otley Road, Headingley Lane in front of me, and opposite is North Lane, which heads off to the cricket ground in Kirkstall. So now I just want to look over the other side here, which is the security fence of the halls of residence. Some lovely trees here. Now we'll have a look in behind here, because this space behind here, currently here, open green, and then we'll get off to here where you can see through there. That's the other end of the green woodland behind the northern end of the Arndale Centre. So since I can't actually get access to it directly, I have to guess, but I think it's approximately half of the length between here and Alma Road. So where you can see the woodland is, that's about halfway. It might be slightly more woodland than grass, but here we have some very nice open bit of grass, nice pleasant quiet semi-rural surroundings for the students over there, and there's their bicycle shed, and why not, lovely nice bit of green here where a two-lane road would be put through with poles and wires. So a 25 to 30 foot strip would have to be cut through that piece of small woodland across here, which is obviously what's been kept clear on this green area here. But behind the wall, further on to the right, we have a mixture of mature trees here, sycamore, rowan or ash, lime, I believe linden trees. Then you can see there's one there, I think that's sycamore. I'll just come up closer and we'll see. And this is where the proposed trolleybus route would come through, two lane wide at least, with poles and electric cables. Obviously all these mature trees would have to come down. Can we see further in? It's kind of difficult. And obviously we have this lovely stone wall here. It's hard to say exactly where the route would be, but I'm understanding that Oakleigh House is scheduled for compulsory purchase and demolition. Obviously we have some kind of mixing of the moving from that route through to here, so perhaps they want to come through here. Obviously you need a bit of room on both sides. There's beautiful, beautiful trees there, obviously many, many years old. I love about Headingley, all these lovely stone pillars, lovely stone walls, character, showing detail, popular in the mid-19th century. These people go past, and so the road would be coming through here, through into here. And I'm just going to see if I can find anybody here who might actually be available to give me permission to film around the back, because I think it would be a great tragedy to lose or any of this area around here. Although I think I might, before I do that, I might just go and have a look at this pathway here, because it looks like there may be another private access here. Let me this looks like just flats, so I think I can just go in here and just take a brief shot there. Well, look, I mean, we're looking into some very fine, nice, very rural kind of area here. Look at that, absolutely beautiful, semi-wild bit of garden, woodlands, all about, well, I don't know exactly, but certainly within 2 miles, I would guess, of Leeds City Centre. And there would be a whole lot of regrading, re-levelling. Obviously, the quiet nature of this road would be changed. I know the trolley buses are going to be electric, so they're not going to make noise as such, but the intrusion of losing beautiful rustic surroundings is, I mean, I think this is the worst thing that could happen. I bet that's an absolute wonder for children to play in, a bit of gardening. Right, so here, well, I'm just going to see if I can find anybody. If I can't find anybody, I will just have to pass up on this and then go around the other side if I can. We'll see how it goes. Okay, righto, well, there was nobody available to give me permission, so I'm just walking back out. But I'm just giving you a view of the trees opposite that would have to come down for this insane Headingley bypass measure, and I've also just had a quick look at a plan and of the proposed network, and this spot here, which is the private pedestrian access for the students from a resident, this is where, because of course there would be a main kind of stop point here, so this is actually where the Headingley Central terminal would be. So of course it would become extremely busy with people at rush hour, and all these trees, we can kind of see the broad swathe where it comes across here and then back into this beautiful Oakleigh house that I've just gone and knocked on the door of and found nobody available. All along here, very nice and quiet. It's a bank holiday afternoon. All looks very nicely lived in. Righto, well, I'm just going to move along back to the main road and walk around. There we are, one final shot of those beautiful trees. And a hidden garden world behind there of trees.